Good evening students, in the previous class we have seen and we started modifications of leaves, and in that we started the first modification, that is tendrils, leaf tendrils. Means in some plants complete leaf may be modified into tendril, or any part of the leaf is modified into tendril. Tendrils are coiled, wiry, sensitive, delicate structures. They will coil around a support and they are responsible for the support, to give support for climbing of the plants. So generally weak stemmed plants possess this type of modifications. First tendril modification, I remember we have given tendrils, leaf tendrils. In this first example, entire leaf or complete leaf modified into tendril. The example is Lathyrus. Where I have shown the diagram like this. Here structures are there which are called appearing like leaves, leaf like structures one, and another one this side. These structures here somewhere a coil structure arises. This is nothing but complete leaf is modified, and these leaf like structures are called stipules. Stipules are looking like but a real leaf is modified into tendril. Second example we have seen terminal leaflets. Are modified into tendrils. Examples we have seen pea plant, garden pea, Pisum sativum. In this, it is a compound leaf. Unipinnate compound leaf. In this it is a peripinnate, equal number of leaflets at the base. Terminal leaflets are modified into tendrils. Terminal leaflets are modified into tendrils. Third example I am going to show, stipules are modified into tendrils. Stipules are modified into tendrils. Examples: smilax, here this is the diagram node. Smilax, here stipules are modified into, but actually they were looking like tendrils, but they were in reality they were stipules. Another examples, leaf tip or leaf apex modified into tendril. Gloriosa. Gloriosa superba plant, which belongs to Liliaceae, leaf tip is modified into tendril. Leaf tip is modified into tendril, tip of the leaf. In some other plants, leaf petiole and rachis modified into tendril. Example, clematis. Here, leaf petiole modified into tendril. Another example, upper part of petiole modified into tendril. So, my dear students, in the NCERT textbook, as per the scheduled or prescribed syllabus, generally they used to give one or two examples, but as the subject matters from the previous years or olden days from the scheduled syllabus of PUC under the tendril or leaf modification, so many examples are cited. In one or other examination at national level, they have asked these questions, examples. So suppose they will give matching block, they will give examples, which part is modified into tendril, all this material is useful. Upper part of the petiole modified into tendril, example, Nepenthes, pitcher plant. Pitcher plant, which is an insectivorous plant. In the previous class, we have seen first two, that is complete leaf modified into tendril, and second one where terminal leaflets are modified into tendril. In today's class, from here, stipules are modified into tendrils. Example, Smilax. To get idea, leaf tip is modified into tendril, leaf petiole and rack is modified into upper part of the petiole. What is this? Let us see. This is Nepenthes plant. The lower part looks like leaf-like structure, winged, expanded, leaf-like, but it is not leaf, it is a petiole. And the upper part becomes tendrilar, modified. Tendrilar. And it produces a sac-like structure. A sac-like structure. This total is called a leaf. So, unimaginable unless we know this biology. This is called lower part of petiole. Part of petiole expanded or winged structure like leaf. It appears like leaf because it has to show photosynthesis, prepare food material. Wing, winged structure. This is called upper part, lower part, upper part. Upper part of the petiole. Upper part of petiole becomes tendril. And this is called leaf lamina. Here, leaf lamina becomes a sac-like structure, which is called pitcher. This is the tip of the leaf, which is formed into a lid-like structure, covering-like structure, but it is not movable. It is immovable. Inside this sac-like structure, acid juices are there, acidic juices, which are going to trap the insects. They will break, digest the proteins of the insect. From them, they will get amino acids. From the amino acids, they will get nitrogenous components. So, how many? A, B, C, D, E, F. 6 types of tendrilar modifications are there. Out of these, in the NCERT book, they have provided only one. That is, they have given example, tendrils are responsible for climbing purpose. And example cited in the NCERT book, only P, Pisum sativum, garden P. But all these examples, as a matter of fact, we have to study in order to write examinations of competitive level smooth way. Now, the second modification they have cited in the book is for protection from grazing animals. In some plants, leaves are modified into spines. Second one. Leaf modification into spine. In some plants, either complete leaf is modified into spine, or any part of the leaf is modified into spine, which protect for protection. And for to escape transpiration. They have given only one example, that cactus plant or cacti plant. In cactus plants, like first one, A. In cactus plants like Opuntia, Euphorbia, leaves are completely modified. Complete leaf is modified into spine. Complete leaf. Here, in Opuntia or Euphorbia, which belongs to Cactaceae family members, are arid or sandy region plants of deserts, are xerophytic nature. Xerophytic means dry nature, where water is very less or no water. So, in no water conditions or waterless conditions, or arid conditions or desert conditions. If these plants possess leaves, leaves are having a miraculous function like exchange of gases by the expanded portion lamina. By possessing numerous small pores called stomata, water will be sent out in the form of water vapor by a process called transpiration. So here, if these plants being desert plants, when there is no water at all, if they develop leaves, so they will be transpired water. So they want to escape from this process. They want to keep up that water in its body for its function, physiology. So they have modified the leaves into spines. Completely, they can stop process of transpiration. Examples we have cited, diagram we have given in previous classes. This flattened structure is called phylloclade. Phylloclade, example Opuntia, Euphorbia, cylindrical structures where complete leaves are modified. Cactus plants. Spines, second example, in some plants like agave, aloe vera, the tip of the leaf is modified into spine. Here you might have seen agave plant. In previous class also we discussed aloe vera plant. It may be there in houses. Generally you might have seen they shows fleshy leaves and either at the margins or at the tip, generally pointed structure is present. See here. This is agave plant, tip is modified into spine. Tip, spine, agave. Aloe vera you might have seen here also, tip, but the leaves are fleshy leaves or succulent leaves. Leaves succulent. Succulent means which stores food material. Succulent or fleshy. By storing food material in the form of mucilage, water or gelatinous substance, they are becoming thick. So the thickness is called in general fleshy or succulent. And in some plants, stipules are modified into spines. See, in some plants, stipules are modified into spines. Example, Ziziphus. Here, this plant leaves are here, spines. Stipules are modified into spines. In some plants, in plants like Argemone, example, throughout the margin of the leaves, spines are found. Margins of the leaves. Modified into spines. So here, margins of the leaves, a short plant, if you might have seen, so throughout the margins, throughout the margins, throughout the leaf margins, spines are formed. They are responsible for protect the plant from the grazing animals. Responsible for protection of the plants from the grazing animals. Protection. Margins. Protection from grazing animals, the animals which eat these. So if spines are there, animals will not reach them. So how many examples are cited? A, Opuntia cactus. B, tip of the leaf agave and aloe. Stipules are modified. Margins are modified. So in the textbook NCERT, my dear students, they have given only one example. Later, leaf modification to store food material. Leaf modified to store food material, as it is, which is given in an order in the textbook NCERT. Examples: onion and garlic. So in onion and garlic, the base of the leaf is modified in onion, and each and every segment in a garlic is called clove, and all so many cloves are formed in the form of a bunch and covered by white papery structure. So in onion and garlic, which are spices, they were responsible for food material, food stored in leaf bases. So onion, which is studied in stem modifications, bulb. So the bulb, bulged part, is nothing but food material, and it is nothing but base of the leaf, upper part of the leaf also edible. In some plants like Australian acacia, Australian acacia. In this plant, it consists of compound leaf, and leaflets are found on the secondary rachis. The petiole. So in this plant, compound leaf, leaflets are found on the secondary rachis, but these leaflets are not present throughout the life of the plant. They may fall off, they degenerate. So when leaflets are degenerate, how this plant will show photosynthesis to prepare food material? So in such condition, petiole of that leaf is converted and modified into a flat structure which is called phyllode. In some plants like Australian acacia, Acacia auriculoformis, auriculoformis. This is the plant. In this plant, see here, a structure called phyllode. Remember, that is phyllocladd. This structure is called phyllocladd, C-L-A-D-E. But here, this is a different, P-H-Y-L-L-O-D-E. What is this different structure? Let us see here. This is the plant leaf. We'll show here this diagram. Young leaves. Old leaf structure. Green expanded structure where very old leaf. So this structure also we can show like this. Young leaf, see here my dear students, young leaf, pinnately compound leaf, primary rachis, secondary rachis, bipinnate. So here leaflets are found. Somehow this is old, this is young, this is old. When it is becoming, the leaflets are going to degenerate. They will fall off. So what is happening? Slowly a structure is started here, expanded green structure. To this structure we have given the name phyllode. See here, gradually when the plant is growing, this completely last, it has increased in its size. Only one is there here, very old. So here a total leaflets are completely degenerate. Leaflets are completely degenerate. So it becomes expanded green structure for photosynthesis. So what is the function of phyllode? This phyllode, why phyllode is, how phyllode is formed? Phyllode is formed by the degeneration of, degenerate, slowly fall off. When they fall off, how this plant will get photosynthesis? So it is modified to prepare a flat green structure called phyllode. This is responsible for photosynthesis. My dear students, in the textbook, in the leaf modification, they use this word, except this word, that is phyllode. They have not given the word term phyllode, but they have used a green flat structure responsible for photosynthesis. In Australian acacia or Acacia auriculoformis, again in the book they have given, in insectivorous plants, like pitcher plant, which is called nepenthes. Leaf is modified into lower wing. Lower, so what is lower wing? Lower petiole, wing like structure, upper petiole, tendril like structure, lamina, a pitcher which is called sac like structure, tip of the lamina, lid like structure. So one of the following is correct. They may ask tens, twenties, number of questions, innumerable questions. Only thing is, if you are having that capability of listening well and understanding and practicing after that reading, then you have to get analysis of previous examinations from years, any national level examination. In this leaf topic, what are the questions, various types they ask, which is called format of question, question format. In biology, my dear students, I am telling you openly and fairly, everything which is incorporated in the textbook along with the additional matters like this, they used to ask repeatedly. Fundamentally, it is a fixed subject. So here, pitcher plant Nepenthes leaf is modified for what? To get nitrogenous components. Because these plants, I have explained in my previous classes, and I have drawn the diagram just now. Here, the soil which is having deficiency of nitrogen, the soil which is deficient in nitrogen, in such soils generally these plants grow. So when a insectivorous plant becomes insectivorous, why? Because for the sake of nitrogen, because their soils are nitrogen deficient, and nitrogen is a crucial critical element for the growth of the plant body, so they will depend upon insects, and by catching, by trapping the insects, they were able to get their nitrogen requirements. That is how, let us see this again, the same diagram I am going to give. In National Geographic channel, if you watch, they used to show how this picture is developed during rainy season. It emerges like a flower cap, and on this cap, this is called total from here to here leaf. Difficult to believe. This is called from here to here petiole. Petiole. This petiole is again divided into two parts, lower part, upper part. Lower part like a green leaf. Green leaf like expanded wing, but it is not leaf, it is a petiole. Upper part is a tendril, and this is lamina. This is lid, and lid is colored, attractive colored, red, pink mostly. Colored, colorful. Why? Insects which are moving here and there, insects which are moving here and there, they thought that it is a flower petals, and when they were coming nearer to this, by attracting this color of the lid, lid is called tip of the lamina, lamina tip, and this lid is not opening and it is immovable, it is immovable, not able to move, only always like this insect will watch and it will come near this. So inside it is having juices, acidic in nature, and here this is called rim, rim of the pitcher. Near this rim, inside, some nectar glands are present, and with this nectar glands smell will be coming, fragrance. So they are attracted by the color, then they are attracted by the fragrance of the nectar gland which are inside the ridge. Now they will come and sit on the ridge. See here, when an insect come and sit on the ridge, it wants to take the, so the ridge is like this, ridge is like this, here nectar glands are present, this ridge I'm showing you, from here, so insect sat here, it wants to take the, it will sleep because the area here is slippery area, slippery, slippery, like how we will slip near water bodies, like that they will slip and they will dropped, fell down into the acidic. These acids are having proteases. Protease means which will break the proteins. Proteases, the enzymes break proteins to liberate amino acids from the amino acid nitrogen. Simply, it is not going to close. If they want to come up, they cannot come up because of slippery area and hairs are present which are downwards. So this part, if we want to show, we'll show like this. Here this is a ridge. Inside the ridge, inside the ridge, inside the ridge, glands. Nectar glands inside the ridge, nectar, and moreover hairs are present. The hairs are slippery and projecting downwards. If hair is like this, if insect can catch it and come up. If hair is not like, if hair is like this, insect may catch and come up, but hairs are not, hairs are, even if they want to catch and come, they cannot come up because of slippery area. So after some time they will be degraded by the enzymatic activity of the acids, like that, by proteinaceous bodies of the insects. This insectivorous plant is able to get its nitrogenous component. All the best. We'll